Hello everyone, this is Dr. Swati Mishra from International School of Business Management at Suresh Ganviar University, Jaipur. And we will be continuing with our sessions of marketing management, wherein we are going to talk about consumer behavior. And the learning objectives of this session are to introduce the learners to the consumer behavior, to make the learners aware of the consumer interest, to analyze a consumer's purchasing attitude as well as his choice, and to introduce the learner to the terms like selective exposure, selective attention, and selective retention. As far as the learning outcomes are concerned, after this session, the learners will have a great deal of knowledge about consumer behavior. The learners will be aware of the consumer interests. The learners will be carrying a knowledge about the consumer's purchasing attitude and the choices that a consumer makes while making his purchase decision. They will be knowing the terms like selective exposure, attention, and retention also. So we shall start with the main discussion part of this topic. But before that, we need to understand that what is consumer behavior? What is the meaning, importance, and concept of consumer behavior? So before we actually try to understand, the consumer behavior, we need to first understand some important terminologies, and out of which one of the most important terminology is the consumer itself. So whom should a marketer recognize as a consumer is one of the most important answers to be answered. Why? Because one has to actually target a particular segment of the consumers. And to target that segment of the consumer, one has to understand that who is my consumer and who is the customer. So there is a wide difference between a consumer and a customer. You have to understand it thoroughly that your customer may or may not be the end consumer of the product. Your end consumer of the product might be different from the one who is actually making the purchase decision. Okay? So, as far as defining the consumer is concerned, any individual who purchases the goods and services from the market for his or her end use will be called as a consumer. Okay? So, if I want to put it into some simpler words, then a consumer is the one who consumes the goods and services available in the market. For example, a person might purchase a tricycle for his son, or someone might purchase a shirt for himself. So when I give these two examples of a father purchasing tricycle for his son, then father is not the consumer, he is only the customer. But in case where when a person is purchasing a shirt for himself, then he himself is the customer as well as the end consumer of the product. So I hope that I'm making myself absolutely clear when I am trying to introduce you to the terminology of consumer. So whom to consider consumer and who is the customer, that you should be clearly aware of. Next terminology that I want to talk about is the consumer interest. So see, every consumer is or customer is bound to show some inclination towards some particular products or services, right? Sometimes some particular brand, sometimes some particular type of colors or other features of a product. So every consumer has his own interest as far as his purchase behavior is concerned. So consumer interest is nothing but the willingness of the consumers to purchase a product or a service as per their taste, need and coarse pocket, which means whatever his affordability is. So as far as my choice is concerned, my likings are concerned, my interests are concerned, and my affordability are concerned, you know, I will be interested in buying some particular type of brands or products, and I won't be interested in buying some particular types of brands or products. So that is what is meant by a consumer interest. So whenever we are talking about this consumer interest or, you know, choices and preferences, two consumers might have similar requirements, but there is a huge difference in their taste, mindset, as well as their ability to spend on some product. You know, it is very commonly seen behavior that, you know, by ability, I do not mean that only I should have the affordability of that product, but the actual meaning of this is that, you know, some people are more inclined towards very hasty purchases. They just make the purchase without giving too much of thought towards their purchase decision. Whereas some people do a lot of research before purchasing any item. They do a review search and they take out the reviews from the internet. They find out which is the most suitable product. They do a complete comparison between different products and the product of their choice. Then they, you know, also try to find out the most reasonably available price in the market, and then they go for the purchase. Some people have a lot of, you know, bargaining capabilities. Some people don't bargain at all. So there is a, you know, consumer taste difference in everywhere, consumer interest difference also everywhere. So with this, we will move ahead with the topic of discussion and now reach at the main question of the session, which is, what is a consumer behavior? So basically, you know, consumer behavior is in itself a very big branch and is a very detailed study to be understood or studied by any learner or any researcher. So we consider consumer behavior as a branch which deals with the various stages a consumer goes through before purchasing the products or services for his end use, right? So now you are supposed to be understanding these various stages through which a consumer goes through before making that purchase decision, which is also called as the consumer buying process. And consumer buying process has been deeply illustrated by multiple different marketing people, but there is a standard consumer buying process which is understood and taught over the time period, and it should be understood by each and every marketer so that they can actually understand that through which stage or which part of the process a consumer is going through, or maybe their own deal is going through, so that they can apply the correct consumer behavior strategies while making that purchase decision, right? So as we move ahead, you know, this is a question which should be addressed by each and every one of you, that why do you think an individual buys a product, right? Whether it is a need, whether it is a social status, whether it is only for a gifting purpose. Always remember a fact that even people, when they are giving some gift, you know, it is not always the same that every time a person will only gift a product which is needed by somebody or which is liked by the person whom they are giving the gift or the receiver of the gift. But sometimes some gifts are only given as a social status symbol also. Right, that I am going to give give at least this much amount of gift because that suits my social status symbol. And this happens very commonly in Indian society, as far as Indian society is concerned. So, you know, why do you think an individual does not buy a product? That is a more important question, You know, as far as my first question is concerned, I asked you why does a person buy a product? Whether he actually needs a product or he's just buying it for the sake of his social status, or sometimes, you know, a person just buys a product because he's got influenced by someone else who is using that product, or maybe, you know, he's just buying the product to gift it to somebody, right? But now you also have to understand, being a marketer, that, you know, what are the possible reasons which make a person not buy a product. So now we will go through, you know, that particular aspect of understanding that why would a person reject a product or not buy a product. Obviously, the first thing is that maybe he does not have a requirement about it. Although many a times it happens that, you know, we go ahead and we buy some product which are not even needed by us. We have just purchased them for the sake of, you know, trying out that, okay, go, let's just try how this product works. Sometimes we only buy it because, you know, someone else has recommended or someone else is buying, you know, all that things. Sometimes we just come in a peer pressure of social status. So sometimes, you know, maybe I don't require, that is why I don't buy it. Sometimes my income is not so well that I can afford the product. Sometimes it is going out of my budget. Sometimes I have some other financial constraints due to which I am not able to spend money on this product. Maybe I was reconsidering the decision of, you know, buying a new automobile car, but in the same year I have to put my child into college and I have to pay the child's college fees. So in that case, when I have to pay my child's college fees, I will maybe reconsider my decision of actually buying an automobile car. So this is another reason of why a person does not buy a product, due to financial constraints. And of course, you know, it might be because of his taste, that, okay, this does not suit my choice, or it is not meant for me, it is not my cup of tea. So that is why I'm not going to buy this product. So there could be multiple reasons behind a person rejecting or not buying a product. But yes, a marketer has to understand those reasons also very well to be able to, you know, recalculate or manipulate the situation in such a manner that the person agrees to buy your product. So now here is the next question which requires some pondering, and that is, when do you think the consumers actually purchase the product? So, you know, there could be any festive season when a person is purchasing product. Like in my last session also, I had mentioned that, like, if there is, you know, any festival coming, say Christmas is there, and, you know, maybe your birthday is there, or maybe it's your anniversary, or it's a wedding, or any other special occasion which is making you buy a new product. Okay. So there could be multiple reasons behind the stimuli of purchase decision for a consumer. Now that also a marketeer has to understand very well. And that is why at the start of any festive season, the, you know, marketeers are always pre-planned and they are ready to, you know, market their product so well that they get maximum sales during that festive season, or maybe that wedding season. So it is like that. So as a matter of factly, there are several reasons or several factors that would influence a buying decision of a consumer. And they range right from psychological factors, social factors, economical factors, and multiple other factors. So whenever you are trying to study consumer behavior, you actually are trying to explain as to why or why not a consumer buys a product. Secondly, you try to answer as to when a consumer buys a product. And thirdly, how a consumer buys a product. So these are the three main aspects that are, you know, questioned to the consumer, to the that are questioned when a marketeer is making any strategy for, you know, marketing his products. So say, for example, during Christmas, the buying tendencies of the consumers increase as compared to the other months. In the same way, during, you know, Valentine's weeks, individuals are often seen purchasing gifts for their partners. So there are multiple fluctuations in the financial markets. Sometimes there is recession. Sometimes recession decreases the buying capacity of individuals. So in a layman's language, if I want to refurbish the meaning of consumer behavior, then I would say that consumer behavior deals with the buying behavior of an individual, right? So the main catalyst which actually triggers the buying decision of an individual is the need for a particular product or a service. So consumers basically purchase products and services as and when the need arises, right? So say if I suddenly find the need of some new product because, you know, I want a new dress for the upcoming festival of Diwali, then I would go and buy it, right? Now there could be, of course, multiple reasons behind it. And that is why every marketeer has to understand that those reasons which act as the creator of need within the consumers. So according to the famous authors of the books of marketing, Belch and Belch, whenever need arises, a consumer searches for several informations which would help him in his purchase. Okay. So there could be multiple sources of information. Some of them have been mentioned in front of you on the screen also, like any personal sources from where he's getting the information, commercial sources. Personal sources would be like, you know, maybe my friends, my relatives, my peers, my parents, anyone. Then commercial sources are, of course, the company itself, which is doing all the promotional advertising at all and sending the promotional material through different means or different media vehicles. And of course, there are some commercial sites also or commercial magazines which promote, like there are magazines specially for automobiles wherein you can hunt for the best automobile for you, best automobile features for you. There are multiple bloggers who keep blogging on the websites about the latest gadgets in the market. So while making a purchase decision of any new electronic gadget, you can log on to those websites also for making a purchase decision of a new electronic gadget. Similarly, there are multiple other public sources also from where you can gather information. There are, you know, one major source of information can be your personal experience. So personal experience is something on the basis of which your instincts keep changing, your tastes keep changing, and you know that, you know, maybe last time when I made this purchase, I had this type of experience. If it was good, you will be ready to make another purchase decision. If it was not good, then you will be hesitant in making that purchase decision, right? So that is why, you know, these are few sources of information on which, on the basis of which one makes purchase decisions. Similarly, you know, perception also plays a very important role in influencing the buying decision of the consumers. Now, what is meant by this perception, that you have to understand very deeply. Perception could be your any type of experience or any type of idea, ideology, or value or belief which actually frames your imagination or your attitude towards a particular brand or a particular product. So whatever perception you hold about that brand or that product will actually tell you as to, you know, what sort of purchase decision or what sort of decision one is going to make regarding that brand. So buying decisions of the consumer will always depend upon some particular factors. And I have mentioned those factors here in front of the screen also. Like if somebody is sending some messages through advertisements, promotional materials, or anything like that, you know. So obviously, everybody is constantly hit by this promotional material all the time. So human mind also is, you know, very well trained, I must say. Like today, just imagine, since today morning, you all must have seen, or you must all have been bombarded by several advertisements, maybe in the moment you opened your mobile, television, then you turned on your radio, when you flipped the open your newspaper, maybe you were moving out on the roads, you could see different billboards, different banners, different hoardings of different brands. So we are constantly getting exposed to various types of media messages, which all these brands are sending to us so that we get convinced to buy that brand. And even if we don't get convinced, at least we have a recognition about that brand, so that at one point of time when we are going to make that purchase decision, we will buy this brand. So in that case, you know, these advertisements, why are they constantly being thrown on us? Why are we constantly exposed to them? So that we always have a recall in our brain about that brand, right? So, you know, all this promotional material is slowly becoming too much to handle by the consumer. And that is why a consumer very well knows that what do I have to get exposed to? So not all the promotional material and advertisement, you know, excite a consumer or maybe delight a consumer or create a willingness to use that product in the consumer. So consumer does not pay attention to everything that he is viewing or to everything that he is made to come face to face with. So he is interested in only what he wants to see, right? Not everything that is shown to the consumer. Consumer, as I said, I'll repeat once again, I reinforce the fact that consumer will always only see what he wants to see. He will only get exposed to what he wants to get exposed to. Otherwise, the human brain is shut down to the rest of the advertising in which the person is not interested. I hope that I'm making myself absolutely clear to all of you. So that is why, you know, this is when he is not ready to get exposed to everything, it is known as selective exposure. Okay. Now, since a person is exposed also selectively, still if he is bombarded with lots of advertisement and he is not paying attention to everything that he sees, then he only sees the things that in which he is interested. Okay, so such behavior is actually called as the selective attention, that I am paying attention only towards the products that I am interested in or only in the brands that I am interested in. So this will be called what? The selective attention. Now suppose the consumer's interpretation of the media messages or the messages which are sent to the consumer are actually analyzed, then you will find out that consumer interpretation basically refers to how an individual would perceive a particular image or a particular message that is being sent to him. So the way that consumer perceives is actually going to affect a lot in the way he will actually buy the product or the purchasing decision that he is going to make regarding the product. So a consumer would certainly buy something which appeals him the most. He would remember the most relevant and meaningful message, also called as the selective retention. So he would obviously never remember something which he has nothing to do with, और इज नॉट नीडिंग इट और इज नॉट इंटरेस्टेड, ही विल नेवर रिमेंबर इट. वाई शुड ही? बिकॉज ही इज नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन इट. इफ I had been interested in buying a new watch, I would have actually observed each and every advertisement of a wristwatch. But the moment I'm not interested in buying it, I just ignored all these advertisements. And even if it was, aired in front of me or broadcasted in front of me five times, even since today morning, I might not remember even a single one. So that is what is the meaning of consumer interpretation, consumer retention of that particular message that was sent to him. So I will again repeat that a consumer would certainly buy something which actually appeals him the most. He would also remember the most relevant and the meaningful message also, which is also called as the selective retention. He would obviously not remember something which has nothing to do with his needs. So that is what is meant by the main factors of the buying decisions. We have covered 3-4 main factors like selective exposure, selective attention, consumer interpretation, and selective retention. So these are the 4 main terminologies that I wanted to introduce you people to. Now please remember these thoroughly. And with this, we have actually spoken about the, initial introductory aspects of consumer behavior. Although I will again repeat that consumer behavior is a very vast branch in itself, because, it is not a very easy task to understand a consumer psychology. So that is why it is very difficult to understand consumer behavior. But even if you are trying to, get an introductory session of consumer behavior, I think we have had one session and one more session is due. And that is about consumer behavior that I wanted to introduce you people to. So with this, you at least have a basic knowledge of consumer behavior. Now, with this basic knowledge, I want to ask you a few questions. This is my first question to all of you. Although I've already written the answers also on the screen, but still it will help you to understand what kind of MCQs can come on this set, on the basis of this topic. So the first question is, any individual who purchases goods and services from the market for his or her end use is called a customer, b consumer, c both a and b, d neither a nor b, and the answer is b consumer. Here's my next question. When a customer tends to remember the most relevant and meaningful message, it is called as a selective retention, b selective exposure, C, selective attention, D, perception. And the answer is A, selective retention. So here is my third question to all of you. Selective exposure is when A, customer perceives a message differently, B, rejects all the information transferred to him, C, a customer goes through selective messages, D, none of these. And the answer is C. When a customer goes through selective messages, then it is called as a selective exposure. Here is my fourth question to all of you. Consumer interpretation refers to how A, customer gets influenced by the adverts, B, customer retains the information delivered to him, C, an individual perceives a particular product, D, none of these. And the answer is C, an individual perceives a particular message. That is how you refer to consumer interpretation as. Here is my fifth question to all of you. Which of the following are the sources of information for a consumer? A, personal sources, B, commercial sources, C, C, public sources. D, all of the above. And the answer is D, all of the above. Here's my sixth question to all of you. Why does an individual buy a product? A, need. B, social status. C, gifting purpose. D, all of the above. And the answer is all of the above. I told you that a customer might buy a product because he needs it. Sometimes someone buys a product only for his social status symbol and sometimes for gifting purposes. So all of the above is the correct answer for this question. Here's my seventh question. Two customers might have similar requirements, but there is a difference in their A, taste, B, mindset, C, ability to spend, D, all of the above. And the answer is yes, D, all of the above. Here's my eighth question to all of you. Consumer interest is nothing but the willingness of consumers to A, reject the product, B, purchase the product, C, try other products, D, become brand loyal. And the answer is B, purchase the products. So we have reached the second last question of the quiz now. The question number 9 says a customer is necessarily the end consumer of the product. A, true. B, false. It's obviously false because I have already told you in my very initial part of today's session that customer and consumer may or may not be the same. Now, here is the last question, that 10th question for all of you. So the 10th question goes like this. The examples of products whose buying decision is not made by the consumers of the products include A, baby products, B, medicines, C, both of these, D, none of these. And the answer is yes, C, both of these. See, baby products decisions are made by mothers or the parents and not the child themselves. Similarly, medicines buying decisions are actually made by the consultant. The consultant gives in writing that which medicines you have to purchase. So we are almost done with the session. The quiz is over. I hope that you have actually got the zest out of this session, that why exactly, consumer behaviors, understanding and learning required for a marketing manager. So, with the help of consumer behaviors theories, you are far better able to make your own strategies to deal with a particular type of customer. Unless you have that idea of, what type of customers are there, what type of different consumer behaviors are there, you always lack in showing the correct managerial or strategical, ideas and strategical choices while applying it to your business so as to make maximum benefit or maximum revenue out of it. So with this, we have reached the conclusion of the today's session, which was on consumer behavior. So thank you so much for going through my sessions, and I hope that these sessions have been thoroughly informative for all of you. You are gaining quite a lot of knowledge from marketing management, and I hope that you will keep watching the sessions of marketing management, which I am posting on YouTube. So this is Dr. Swati Mishra from International School of Business Management at Suresh Gyan Vihar University, Jaipur, signing off. Thank you. Have a nice day.